Hello, and welcome to today's edition of Bobcat Update. I'm Jared Maxson.
And I'm Autumn Anderson. For today's newscast, we have a story about how Texas State was approved for a new engineering major and about how climate change will affect Texas. The state's Higher Education Coordinating Board has authorized Texas State University to offer a new engineering major. Bobcat Update's Paige Green has the story.
The Ingram School of Engineering will offer a mechanical engineering degree program in the fall of 2022. The program will emphasize Industry 4.0 tools and technologies.
We have the ability to design the courses that we need so that we address that Industry 4.0 component. We also have the ability to include in our classes projects that have relevancy on many aspects of the Industry 4.0 technologies.
Industry 4.0 is a worldwide initiative to make industry systems smart. It focuses heavily on real-time data, machine learning, and automation. This includes the use of core systems like artificial intelligence, cybersecurity, and robotics.
The students with this degree will be able to work in many different industries. So they not only address the need for, you know, the mechanical engineer profession, but they can also work in other similar fields. For instance, they can work in industry, energy industry. They can work in other auto manufacturing companies with the ability to, solve very general problems related to engineering.
Texas State had degree expansion in mind when the construction of Ingram Hall began in 2016.
Well, the university invested early on in these facilities that we have here in Ingram Hall. It had in mind the expansion to new programs, and one of them was mechanical engineering. And we have capacity in the building to offer the labs and the classes.
Texas State is located in the middle of the Texas Innovation Corridor. This provides an ideal setting for the new program. For Bobcat Update, I'm Paige Green.
Texas State has partnered with Dell Inc. to work on some new research initiatives. With Dell's help, the university will have the technologies needed to develop programs involving big data, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. Researchers say they hope to create their own AI models with the technologies. In return, Dell will get benchmark data on the performances of these machines that Texas State uses.
Employers added 571,000 jobs in October. According to a monthly survey released Wednesday by private payroll firm ADP, gains were strongest among large companies, with increases of 342,000 jobs, and were heavily concentrated in the services sector of the economy. The leisure and hospitality industry added 185,000 jobs. Tomorrow, the Labor Department will issue its monthly job numbers for October. Many economists predict a rebound in numbers after disappointing results in September.
Graduation is next month, and Career Services wants Bobcats to be prepared to land their first big job offer. In this Bobcat Update, Megan Einosh looks at the services being provided to students.
Located on the fifth floor of the LBJ Student Center, Career Services provides comprehensive career assistance to students and alumni. From resume and cover letter critiques to mock interviews, career counselors guide prospective applicants through every step.
We offer a lot of services here. They're all kind of focused around helping students get a job or an internship now or a job after they graduate. Students can come in here to get their resume reviewed, they can do mock interviews, they can get their cover letter looked at, or we can give them a guided counseling conversation where we help them find a major, find a job, or, you know, any step along the way.
All services are free and offered for life to Texas State students and alumni.
We're basically focused on like professional development, right? So our main goal is to like get you out of here, basically feeling secure to like either you walk out of like a job lined up, or you just feel secure enough to where you know that you are in the right direction of like what you want to do or what steps you're heading in.
Counselors and associates believe students who use their services have an upper hand in securing a career path after graduation.
Be open to the possibilities that are out there. I graduated from Texas State as well and had no idea what I was going to do with my degree, but I've found my path just by keeping my options open and exploring things.
Career service appointments can be requested through Texas State's Handshake website or by calling 512-245-2645. For Bobcat Update, I'm Megan Einotch.
The Texas State Outdoor Recreation Center has a variety of services for students, faculty, and alumni. Located in Sewell Park, Outdoor Rec sells tents, sleeping bags, coolers, and snorkel sets. It rents watercraft at affordable rates. From now until February 28th, watercraft excluding tubes may be rented for half the regular cost. All rentals can be reserved up to 7 days in advance. During the fall semester, the Outdoor Recreation Center is open from noon until 6 p.m. The Hays County Food Bank is getting ready for the holidays with its 15th annual Thanksgiving Drive. Bobcat Update's Clayton Kelly has a story.
On November 16th at Bobcat Stadium, the Hays County Food Bank will host its Turkeys Tackling Hunger campaign and will provide meals free of charge to families in need. The food bank figures it will serve about 1,000 families that night.
It's going to be a big event. We're going to have people in turkey costumes and signs. And one of the ways that we've kind of adjusted with the pandemic in regards to this campaign is it's a drive-through distribution.
Registration is required for the food drive and can be done online at turkeys.haysfoodbank.org. Meals will be provided on a first-come, first-served basis. Tate says the COVID-19 pandemic has created a greater need for food drives like this one.
There has been a wave of giving. I think it kind of woke up some of our community in regards to just giving back, hosting those food drives, donating money, volunteering, advocating has definitely gone up.
2/3 of the food drive donations come from individuals rather than corporations. Students are encouraged to volunteer. They can help by packaging food or assisting in the distribution process.
I get the satisfaction of being able to help people like within the community, especially since a lot of college students have some issues with the food security.
Food pickups for Texas State students are held Thursdays at the Midi parking lot from 5 to 7 p.m. and food distributions for the general public are every Monday at the San Marcos Public Library at 5 p.m. For Bobcat Update, I'm Clayton Kelly.
Voters in San Marcos on Tuesday chose Mark Gleason and Jude Prather to serve on the city council. Both men have served before. Gleason picked up 54% of the votes in his reelection bid against opponent Zach Zambrano. Prather's race against Mark Rocky Moore was much tighter. Prather defeated Rocky Moore by only a handful of votes. Prather had served on the city council before from 2010 to 2016. Voters also overwhelmingly approved amendments to the city's charter that will set term limits for city council members and the mayor.
Climate change can affect the state's power infrastructure in ways that may lead to future crises. Justin Vicker reports.
Weather events like last year's Snowmageddon and the recent floods in central Texas are likely to happen again and with greater intensity. Texas State Geography Professor Tom Pittock says such events are becoming more frequent due to climate change.
Storms with higher rainfall amounts, higher winds, and on the other side, more sort of longer heat events as well.
Pittock says the Texas power grid is not ready for these inevitable weather events, which means another power crisis can be expected.
We've only just, you know, really started to see the first of what's going to be really common with these large-scale sort of disruptions to the grid and these large-scale sort of events.
Pittock says power consumption needs to be reduced.
This is generally a result of people's relationship with energy. We come home, it's cold, we turn the heat up, have the lights going and the television and the internet. And without really thinking about the consequences.
Pittock says the state's energy infrastructure will remain vulnerable unless citizens put more pressure on the state legislature to fix the problem. For Bobcat Update, I'm Justin Vickers.
Most of the United States will change their clocks this weekend. The nation reverts to standard time on Sunday, so remember to set your clocks back 1 hour before bed Saturday night. The time will change automatically on many devices at 2 o'clock Sunday morning. The time was set forward 1 hour last March for what's called savings time. This has been an annual ritual to accommodate farmers to give them an extra hour of sunlight for planting and harvesting. I'm really glad our phones do that for us because I would never remember that.
No doubt. What would we do without them? Well, from everyone here at Bobcat Update, thank you for watching and we'll see you next time. I'm Jared Maxson.
And I'm Autumn Anderson.